welcome on board the Election Express. We are broadcasting tonight from the Marine Drive in Mumbai. And we've been traveling through the day across India's commercial capital to get a sense of what people on the ground feel about the battle for your vote 2014. I'm joined at the Islam Gymkhana tonight by the real Aam Aadmi of Mumbai. People who've got questions that have been building for the last 5 to 10 years, and there's a cross-representation of politicians to answer those questions. Can we have a warm round of applause for all of you who've gathered over here to join us on the Election Express? Thank you so much, means a lot to us. I want to start by asking two special guests who've joined us on this program. You know, we've seen this one letter that's been written, signed by several people in Bollywood, all of them saying, don't vote for communal forces. Usually, from what I've seen, Bollywood is very apolitical. They don't want to mess with the politicians because they feel it'll impact their films, it'll impact turnover. This is the first time we've seen Bollywood take on communal forces, which essentially, in your sense, I presume, means, Mr. Modi, you want to keep Modi out. Why?
No, I don't think there was any particular intention to keep Mr. Modi out. See, I'll tell you what it came out of. On the one hand, we do believe that the one quality which is truly extraordinary, unique, and most beautiful about this country is the diversity, is the fact that we're a pluralistic society, and under the umbrella of secularism, we can all sort of live securely. On the other hand, you notice that in the political discourse today, while elections are going on, the most critical election taking place, secularism as a concept is out of the public discourse. No one talks about it. If anyone even dares to raise it, he's labeled a pseudo-secularist, abused, and thrown out of there. So secularism seems to be equated with...
Secularism is also a badly used word.
Possibly, but the fact of the matter is that for lack of a better term, I'm talking about that umbrella under which the diversity of India actually thrives. So we merely asked voters to try and reflect on that. Whatever be your definition of secularism, reflect on that such that you choose a candidate which actually belongs to a party which has this as a central thing in it.
You may couch what you're saying in a very open framework, but essentially what you're saying is keep Modi out. Why is it that 60 signatories and some very renowned names have come together to tell the people that you're scared of Modi or India should be scared of communal forces?
Well, I think it's not that simple, because in India we don't get to vote for a prime minister. We get to vote for the best representative from our area. So I think this is another way to remind people, look at the person, the choices you have in front of you, vote for that person. It's not necessary that by voting for X, Y will become prime minister. That's not the way the presidential system works that way in the US. It doesn't work that way here. So I think you choose the best representative, you have the best chance of holding on to the principles in our constitution.
Also, in answer to your question as to why is it that Bollywood, as you call it, has suddenly come out, which is regarded to be apolitical and usually plays it safe, I think it's also a measure of the nervousness which people feel, particularly the young people. They do feel that this notion which they hold very dear is perhaps vulnerable, is under threat.
Okay, so the point that you're making, and shared by several very big voices in Bollywood, is that the notion of secularism, and China NC representing the BJP is also joining us here at the Marine Drive, is under threat. That if Narendra Modi were to come to power, somehow the secular fabric that holds India together will be ruptured. How do you answer, Mr. Sippy, and all those who've signed this petition?
Who decides who's secular and who isn't? Is it going to be 60 signatories, or is it going to be crores of Indians that finally take a call? And who's to say somebody is pseudo-secular or somebody is secular? For 60 years in this country, we have only seen divide and rule. We have only seen appeasement politics. We have only seen vote bank politics. When somebody comes to the forefront and talks only development, when one talks about development, am I asking him what community he belongs to, him what he belongs to, or are we thinking of the nation as a whole? I don't think we need any certificate from any community. My appeal to them would be, they are free in a democracy to write what they want in this petition, but the issues they should be addressing is corruption, price rise, unemployment, women's security, and serious issues. To act under this garb of secularism and to suggest that, you know, Narendra Modi is communal is absolute hypocrisy.
Okay.
And just to conclude, one last point which is very important. The petition should have said, they plea every single Mumbaikar and every single Indian to vote for the candidate that he or she thinks is best, rather than putting something for them.
Okay, let's take more questions. Yes.
On a platter.
What is the BJP's policy
towards people from UP, Bihar and Gujarat, who are all regarded by some parties in Bombay as outsiders, working and living happily in Bombay? And secondly, will they take the support of parties who oppose this, who are quite in the forefront in Bombay, like the Shiv Sena and the MMS?
No, are you saying that outsiders are not welcome to Mumbai?
They are not. Some parties really...
What's your point? I'm asking you.
Outsiders are absolutely welcome, and I think that is under threat if the BJP comes and with the...
Why is the BJP flirting with MNS and in bed with the Shiv Sena given the view that they have on outsiders?
Please, yes. Let me clarify. The BJP is an all-inclusive party. We've never ever made a single statement to suggest that nobody is welcome to the city or the state. We have in fact said that love the state, love the city, respect it. I don't think the Shiv Sena either has ever made a derogatory comment or has, for that matter, despite the issues we face. Yes, we do have influx problems. We do have infrastructure problems. All of those need to be addressed. But unfortunately, the members of parliament who are always absconding, as they are on your show too, I don't think I've answered.
Okay. How do you answer that question, ma'am?
I'd like to answer this question particularly because there's a lot of misconception about Shiv Sena. Shiv Sena also believes in inclusive politics. It does not believe in, you know, because this is a democratic country and everybody is allowed to work and go anywhere, wherever they want, wherever work is there. Only issue with Mumbai is that Mumbai is not growing. The infrastructure is falling short. That is the key issue which needs to be
addressed. No, but you've been running the local bodies and have done nothing about it.
No, you've had so much of an opportunity. This is a false
Mumbai, unlike say Delhi, where there's a visible difference and Delhi is better off than it was 10-15 years ago, under your reign, Mumbai is falling apart and you're responsible for it.
No, I will...
Do you know what a Herculean task it is to even give basic facilities to this city?
Which you failed in.
One moment. Please read the NSSO report which says that you have 29% of slums of India in Maharashtra, 9% in Mumbai.
So who's allowed them to come up? It's politicians such as your party that have allowed these slums to come up. Because you're hoping that would be a vote bank for you. Why is it, and this is a question that I think as we travelled across Mumbai, we felt very closely. The infrastructure under your watch is crumbling and you simply have not been able to cope with it.
I think we are digressing from the question which gentleman asked about...
But this is an uncomfortable question, so you want to digress. Why don't you answer my question?
I will answer that also, if you allow me to talk. The thing is that Uddhavji Thackeray, the party president of Shiv Sena, had floated a concept of Mi Mumbai Kar, which was an idea of including every single person who lives in this Mumbai, who loves the city and who also contributes as a citizen to the city. It is always that they expect something from Shiv Sena or from the person who's governing the municipal council. So the idea was to include everybody, respect your city and love your city. So the misconception about Shiv Sena that it is not welcoming the outsiders, etc., first of all, is not true. And the second point which you raised was about Mumbai, you know, growing, getting into a very bad shape, etc. The reality is not so. If you look at the medical hospitals, the virtual classrooms in Mumbai today, in the BMC schools, or if you look at the BMC maintained roads, if you look at
those
the
are
water
claims.
Supply,
let me put
no,
those claims to test. One second. The BJP Shiv Sena, which run the BMC thing, they've done a great job in improving infrastructure. How many people share that position, that the BJP Shiv Sena, I can only see those who are from the BJP, or are you, I want the Aam Aadmi to put out their hands. How many Aam Aadmi, the real Aam Aadmi, not the ones belonging to Kejriwal's party, but the real Aam Aadmi feel that the BJP Shiv Sena have done a good job? Okay, so there are a couple of hands, but very few. How many feel that the BJP Shiv Sena together have let down Mumbai and infrastructure? Shaina, don't put your hand up. That's not for you to put your hand up. She's putting her hand up. Okay, how many feel the BJP Shiv Sena have failed? I think there are more people who believe that the BJP Shiv Sena have failed than there are those who believe that infrastructure in Mumbai is keeping up with the requirements of the city. I also want to welcome to the program at this time, Milind Diora. You've had a long, tiring day, I see. Welcome. Walking in a little late, but nonetheless, it's great to have you with us. What we want to do right now is play out a report that we filed earlier in the day at the Meaty Bike College, the heart of a lot of educational institutes in Mumbai. We went there at their adda to speak to the young people of Mumbai and understand from them what they felt were the answers to the questions that confront them. Here's what we found out. We're in the coolest hangout zone
the cafeteria area of one of the biggest educational hubs in Mumbai to understand what the youth of India think, what the youth of Mumbai think about the battle for your vote 2014. We're also joined by youth icon Chetan Bhagat, and a lot of young people just about gotten over. We're taking pictures with Chetan Bhagat. Finally, we've been able to get them all to sit down. Thank you all very much for joining us on the Election Express. I want to begin by asking you, what according to you are the biggest problems you face in India, and who do you think has the solutions to solve those problems?
See, firstly, the problems related to women, like there have been so many issues that have come up recently, like rape cases and molestations and so on. So I think women is the main thing which we should look forward and the main problem we should go towards to sort out. And I would like, personally, I would be voting for BJP because, you know, the improvement which I have seen and seeing Gujarat coming up so fast, so I think he can be the one who can, you know, lead the country well.
All girls here, I want to ask you this, because some people tell me this, that sometimes girls, they tell girls that if BJP comes, they'll be very strict on girls, on what they can wear and this. Have you guys heard that? Have you heard that about Modi?
Pubs, partying, they go and attack. Some of the organizations affiliated with the larger Hindutva family, not so much the BJP itself, have attacked pubs in Mangalore. They want deadlines to be much stringent. Some people say there should be no alcohol. They're fringe elements.
What I feel that stopping someone or stopping girls will not be solution. You should create a environment where girls can thrive. Not, you should stop rapes rather than letting stopping women from going out.
Girls don't feel safe in Mumbai because Mumbai is considered one of the safest.
I'm from Delhi and I feel quite safe in Mumbai.
You feel safe?
I've always been in Mumbai since 23 years, and Mumbai is a relatively safe city. But last year when I went to Gujarat in Vadodara, it's amazing. We were on the highway at 3 a.m. in the morning, only girls in a car. It was absolutely safe. I was there for a weekend, and even based on what my friends have told me, I think Gujarat is really one step forward.
They say that because Modi comes from a humble background, a very simple, impoverished background, he understands the problems of common people more than Rahul, who was to the manor born.
Yeah, he was born with a silver spoon.
What about Rahul as well?
Yeah. Okay, let's get to that then. What about AAP? What about Arvind? I mean, how do you guys see that now?
I think AAP had a very good chance. Probably Arvind Kejriwal had a very good chance when he was elected as a CM of Delhi, but he resigned, and that kind of was a disappointment for the youth. That why is this that?
We do not want to give a hope to the nation, but left the country choiceless. Is what I would.
The problem is that he quit. He did not try to change whatever is happening. So we youth, especially youth, cannot trust anybody who quits in between. Right. We want a sustaining leader.
Right. He asked the people of Delhi before taking the seat. He never asked them before he quit. I don't think that's right.
Are you voting for Modi or are you voting for BJP? Are you voting for Shiv Sena? What, when you go in there, what are you thinking?
I think Modi. I'm going to vote for Modi. It's BJP.
See, what the local parties do, it's really communist. They focus only on their local people. They do not think for the country. I'm a Maharashtrian, but I feel that MNS only concentrates on Maharashtrian. So that's
now,
not...
This is really nice because I'm really getting insights here. I mean, okay, this constant debate I've done in Rahul's studios, but is there a Modi wave? What do you guys think?
Definitely, you see on the campaigns, the social media holdings, like they have this particular agency. So, but kind of strategy that they have been, we have been reading Economic Times, we have been following Modi's campaign, social media. He started in March, but the kind of race that he leads right now, like Congress had started campaigning since January, and they started in March. Just within a month, people are like Modi fans.
Everyone over here seems to believe that just having a surname called Gandhi is not enough. What do you think Rahul needs to do to get things right from here on?
I think I like this Rahul.
That's his key of being on primetime television.
This is the Rahul we want.
But I'm not in politics. So you tell me, what do you think, if you were strategizing for Rahul Gandhi, what do you think he needs to do?
Well, he needs to think of these people as really important, I think. I think they have things to say. I mean, it's not like they have something personal against him. He's somewhere down the line, he seems to have disappointed them. And
why are you disappointed with Rahul?
Come up with something new. Like, we are just done, we are developing, we are going ahead. Come with something new which, like, you know, fulfills what we all need now.
Are you disappointed with Rahul Gandhi?
Yes, of course. It's not just Rahul Gandhi, actually whole Congress. Congress had 10 years to change the country. And in 10 years, a lot of things could have been done which is not done.
You know, in the last part of this discussion, I want to talk about those who are uncomfortable with Modi. Whether we like it or not, there is a reality that there are people uncomfortable, they don't know what will happen, they are deeply concerned. Do you think Modi has not done enough to bring them on board?
What do you guys think? There are these riot charges, you know that, right? There are these now corporate crony capitalism charges, all these charges are there. But do you trust Modi or do you, what is it?
I feel that now we are looking for a change, and secondly, why see the negative part? I mean, he's done a lot of good things as well. Look at the good part and change the leader and let's just move forward.
But thank you all very much. It's interesting to be out of the studio, speaking to real people, understanding their real issues, and that's the whole purpose of the Election Express being out and about. Thank you all very much for taking our time out and joining us in your canteen. Thank you, Chetan.
Thank you. Please watch Two States also.
Now, everyone who's been waiting to take pictures with Chetan, here's your chance. Thanks, Chetan.
Thank you.
So much hope, so much aspiration there amongst the youth. What I want to do is use this opportunity to give the real Aam Aadmi an opportunity to ask questions to the people we've lined up here in Mumbai. Yes, sir. What's your question?
Firstly, I would like to welcome Shri Milind Devra, who I haven't seen in the last 10 years. I walk every day at Marine Drive, twice a week at PDP, once a week at Mahalakshmi Racecourse. Except for the election time, I haven't seen him. And now he's going all around asking for votes. I haven't seen any significant improvement in South Mumbai, whether it's security or roads. He can blame the BMC or whatever the alliance is who's running BMC, but what has he done as our South Mumbai MP to improve infrastructure, education, the policy paralysis? We've had a gang rape in South Mumbai which we've never heard of in the last 20 years.
You're saying Milind is visible only election to election, and they want to know from you, your voters, and we're in South Mumbai, Milind, what have you done and why should they vote for you again?
Yeah, well, firstly, this young friend of mine who walks, did you say on Marine Drive regularly? So the first thing I tell him is that the entire Marine Drive beautification project, which happened about 6 years ago, was an initiative by me, which the entire Marine Drive associations, there's about three of them, who are completely apolitical, who use that, senior citizens who walk on Marine Drive every day. They've lauded my efforts in terms of getting the refurbishment of Marine Drive passed. The government spent a lot of money, did it very well with citizen participation. There's phase two of that Marine Drive beautification happening, which will be thrice more elaborate than the first phase. So I've always thrown my weight behind a lot of key infrastructure projects. I don't claim to say that it's possible for every MP in every part of India to meet about 3 million of their constituents and to meet each and every one. There'll obviously be people who will say, I haven't seen my MP. That's just the nature of the fact that each MP represents about 3 million people in this country. But I've always thrown my weight behind large important projects. I'm glad this young friend of mine walks on Marine Drive, and I hope he'll credit me for the refurbishment of Marine Drive on which he walks. And I'm sure in a few years' time, in about 4 years' time in particular, he'll be very, very proud of phase two of that redevelopment.
But why is there so much anger? We spend the day travelling through your constituency, other parts of Mumbai. There's a lot of anger amongst the young people, amongst the voters of Mumbai, with your government. Not just South Mumbai, with the UPA government. And you've been a minister in this government. There's so much anger. It seems there's an upsurge of anger against you.
Well, look, we've been in government for 10 years. Anyone who's been in government for that long, There's bound to be anti-incumbency. I'll be foolish if I deny that. And there's anti-incumbency at many levels. If you look today at a local level, for example, in Mumbai city, where if you look at BMC issues, local issues, sanitation, public schooling, hospitals, roads, water, like Shiv Sena, for example, which is in power in the BMC, there'll be anti-incumbency against them also with regards to local issues. So anti-incumbency is a part and parcel of politics. I think ultimately what people have to try and do is understand which candidate has represented them, has spoken out for them, has raised his or her voice, and been courageous enough to raise a voice even if it means going against his own party. That's truly being independent and speaking from the heart. And I've tried to display those kind of characteristics as an MP of South Mumbai for the last few years.
Okay, let's take some more questions. The gentleman has a question. Yes, sir.
Why political party RTI से क्यों डरती है और अभी सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने उनको नोटिस भेजा है कि उनको फॉरेन फंडिंग मिलती है तो RTI के अंडर आने से क्या मोदी के चाय के चर्चे के खर्चे जो होते हैं अंबानी और अडानी देते हैं उस पर कोई
श चाइना आंसर दैट क्वेश्चन कि ये मोदी इतने सारे एड कैंपेन निकाल रहे हैं सब जगह पे, कौन फंड करता है इसको?
खुशी दे रहे हैं पीपल हु
नहीं, कौन खुशी खुशी दे रहा है आप बता दो इनको, ये पूछ रही है आपसे.
एवरीथिंग दैट यू नीड टू नो, एवरीथिंग दैट यू नीड टू फंड,
फॉरेन फंडिंग मिलती है बीजेपी एंड कांग्रेस को.
Notice one moment, Supreme Court
will you please
notice?
Listen to me, I happen to be the treasurer okay. of the state, so I would have an answer for you.
No, so why don't you just declare who's funding
that's,
you?
That's exactly what I'm saying. Everything is, there is a question whether everything should be under public domain, because the people who donate legitimately also sometimes want a certain kind of, you know, they don't want their names disclosed. But however, we file our returns, we file all our papers, the income tax, the election commission no. runs through everything. All the people who
now
are
I want to do a show of hands. We've heard this answer very often. Do you think it's okay for both big parties like the Congress and the BJP not to disclose their funders? Or do you think the Aam Aadmi, the real Aam Aadmi, wants to know who funds Milind and China's campaigns? How many people feel that there should be greater public disclosure, regardless of who's donating? People should know where the money is coming from. You know, I think Milind, this is a good show of hands. You've taken up many causes against your party's wishes. Why haven't you taken this one up?
I did, in fact, when there was a discussion in the country on when the Chief Information Commissioner of India said that political parties, two parts of political parties should be made public. One is internal communication and two is their accounts. Like China said, every political party has to file their account before the Election Commission and Income Tax. And there was a big hue and cry amongst all political parties, to be fair. The entire parliament felt that it's not fair to let the internal communication of a political party be made public.
No, the question here is only funding. So you want to know who's funding your campaign.
So in terms of funding,
are you prepared to declare here who's funding your campaign?
I'm funding my campaign. There's nobody else funding my campaign.
So where are you getting the funds to fund your campaign?
From my own account.
No, so you're saying you don't take money from big corporate.
No, I don't.
A lot of stories in South Mumbai, a lot of money is coming into campaigns, not just your campaign, but other campaigns as well.
Now look, there are a lot of stories about a lot of things, a lot of stories about media also.
Sure. We're public listed, so all the funding is out. Why don't you also declare list publicly?
Well, so that's what I'm saying. So coming back to my point that I was one of the few people in parliament who actually cut across party lines, and there's colleagues of mine, for example, from Biju Janata Dal, from Orissa, from other political parties, and we joined together and created an informal group of parliamentarians and said that before any decision is taken by parliament with regards to allowing or disallowing political parties' accounts be made public, this should be sent to a parliamentary standing committee to study it. And it's a big victory in my view, because it's a victory for democracy, and it's a victory because that parliamentary standing committee, ultimately when they decide on whether it should or shouldn't be done, they will allow and invite people to testify before it, and ultimately the decision will be
taken. No, but the will of the people doesn't matter, because they're only interested in protecting themselves. That young gentleman has a question.
Yes. You take up the issue of legalizing slums every single election, but when it comes to legalizing or doing anything concrete for Campa Cola, you just go and speak to them and do nothing by the end of the day. So, I mean, what are you going to do something for them, or just the slums? I don't know. People who pay taxes should be deserved, should be rewarded by the end of the day. Don't you think so?
Well, listen, firstly, I think nobody can deny that I played a lead role in raising the Campa Cola issue in the public domain.
We all did. Please give credit.
Okay, China also was there. There were people from other parties also were present. And I'm all for giving them the kind of support they need. And it's not about slums versus non-slums. If you are an advocate of Campa Cola, you would be doing injustice to them by comparing them to slums. Because what it's about is Campa Cola colony is a great case of where there's a builder-official nexus, not in Mumbai, but probably in any city in the country, and where builders often dupe homeowners and home buyers. And many decades later, people who were given that FSI, the permissible FSI, suddenly they were asked by the court to demolish that. So all I can say to you is that I'm doing my level best with the residents of Campa Cola, with the state government, to find a solution to them, because I believe it's very important not to send out a message to builders that they can get away with this. I think it's important to send a message.
No builder
to
ever gets arrested. No builder ever gets moved.
So I'll come to the point. So one is, it's important to send a message to future homeowners that they will be protected. And that's why today, as part of my election campaign, one of the biggest testimonials I've got is from the residents of Campa Cola, who've asked and appealed to voters to say, please vote for Milind Deora. Now, coming to a solution for the future, In fact, that's what something I tweeted today. If you look at my tweet today, it's a tweet from Kampa Kolaru appealing to
the... I think you need to address that.
Yeah, no, now coming to a very important solution, which I think Rahul is important for Election Express since you're traveling around the country. Today, Maharashtra is the first state in the country and the only state in the country that has a housing regulator that will prevent any Kampa Kola from happening in Maharashtra state. And I think that's a big achievement. Because looking at it prospectively, that's something which Mumbai and Maharashtra shouldn't be unique. And I think that's something that should spread to every city and every state in the country. Because this builder official nexus is something I see in Delhi, I see it in Bangalore, I see it in Chennai, I see it in Kolkata, I see it in Mumbai.
The builders don't get punished, the officials don't get punished, and the netas who break all rules get tickets on the Congress party.
But they're not on the Congress party, you get it on every political party.
But also on your party.
I don't deny that.
You're preaching about what might happen.
I don't deny that, but I'm saying what is
the solution? But why did Ashok Chavan get a ticket then?
Well, look, why did Ashok Chavan get a ticket?
So you're saying all of this, then the one who's been found guilty and indicted by a committee set up by your government is given a ticket by your party. So all of what you're saying is meaningless after that.
Rahul, to be fair, listen, again coming back to the Adarsh point, rather than why somebody got a ticket is something why the party decided.
No, you're part of the party. Now you can't distance yourself.
I'm not distancing myself. I'm saying you will remember that I was, again, one of the first people who spoke out that the Adarsh investigation should be complete and we have nothing to hide. So look, the system isn't perfect. Congress isn't perfect, BJP sure enough isn't perfect, sure enough Aam Aadmi Party isn't perfect, sure enough Shiv Sena, MNS and other parties in Mumbai and Maharashtra aren't perfect. So anyone who says they are perfect is just flat out lying to the public.
Okay.
But I think ultimately what matters is good people in each of those parties to come together to raise a voice on behalf of the people fearlessly. And that's something I've demonstrated in the last few years, and that's why I believe the people of South Mumbai will re-elect me.
Okay. We've got the people of South Mumbai with us, also those who hope to represent them across political parties. But I want to focus right now on the big issue of migrants, an issue that is exploited by parties on both sides of the spectrum. One threatens to throw them out, the other wants to stand up and protect them. What do the migrants, who increasingly constitute an ever-growing part of Mumbai's voting population, think of the battle of Your Vote 2014? My colleague Sini Pasha files this story tonight.
A thriving metropolis with a population of 20.7 million. Mumbai is the financial, commercial and entertainment capital of India. The capital city of Maharashtra, Mumbai attracts lakhs of people every year in search of employment, money and fame. This influx of migrants to the maximum city has today become the center of a heated political debate. The Thackeray cousins, Raj and Uddhav, with their Sons of Soil agenda, claim that the outsiders are depriving local Maharashtrians of job opportunities.
या दिल्ली वाल्यांचा जो एक त्यांची इच्छा जी आहे ना इतक्या वर्षांची की या महाराष्ट्रापासून मुंबई स्वतंत्र करायची.
Bhairambada in Bandra East is Mumbai's very own UP hub. With a huge Samajwadi Party office, this area proudly wears its regional identity on its sleeve. People here firmly believe that the MNS and Shiv Sena's outsider-insider rhetoric is merely a tactic deployed to consolidate their Marathi vote bank.
Har jagah UP wale hai, koi bhi line mein jao UP wale jyada hai. Taxi hoye, rickshaw hoye, ya ready made aap jo suit pehne hai, wo sab pure UP wale hai. Kaam to hamara hi hota hai matlab. मगर नाम नहीं हो पाता क्या कर रहे हम हर चीज हम लोग का नाम होता है
गलत बात है ना सबका योगदान है
बांट के वोट इकट्ठा करना नहीं खुद अपने हीरो बनना चाह रहे हैं ये बंटवारे वाली जो बात करते हैं वो गलत राजनीति करते हैं
जो मेहनत करता है उसको जो है ना काम मिलना चाहिए
54-year-old Lakhanlal Janardhan Tiwari came to the city with his parents when he was barely 3 months old. A pandit from Jaunpur district of Uttar Pradesh, Tiwari claims that no one can challenge his right to work in Mumbai.
मेहनत करना नहीं चाहते महाराष्ट्र में एक
प्रवृत्ति रही है पहले, अभी तो लोग करने लगे हैं क्योंकि हमें देखकर वो खुद भी बदलाव में आ गए। हम लोगों में ऐसा है कि मेहनत जब करता है आदमी, पसीने से अपना गाराता है, तो उसको वेस्टेज नहीं करता, खर्च नहीं करता, उसको फालतू में खर्च नहीं करता, क्योंकि उसका परिवार गाँव में होता है। वो अकेला यहाँ पे मेहनत करके कमा के सोचता है हम गाँव वाले अपने परिवार को जिलाए। आज यहाँ के स्थानीय महाराष्ट्रियन 25% है, 75% आउट प्रांतीय लोग हैं।
And Tiwari is not the only one who believes that the MNS and Shiv Sena's divisive politics is creating problems for the people on the ground.
हम लोग अपने हिसाब से गाड़ी चलाते हैं, ठीक है? कोई भी आया, ए भैया गाड़ी हटा, ये कोई बोलने का तरीका नहीं है। मीन्स हम लोग तो ये है नहीं कि उनके पास कोई जा रहा है और हम छीन के लेके आ रहे हैं, हमारे पास लेके आ रहे हैं, ऐसा तो कुछ है नहीं। वो पर्सन हमारे पास आता है, गाड़ी में बैठता है, तो हम लोग उसको ले जाते हैं। अगर उसमें कोई ये बोलता है कि हम उनको बेरोजगार कर रहे हैं, उनकी रोटी हम खा रहे हैं, ऐसा कुछ नहीं है।
43-year-old मोहम्मद ताहिर खान runs a transport company in Mumbai. He claims his employees are often targeted by MNS workers because of their regional identity, forcing them to live in constant fear.
जब राज ठाकरे जी को अरेस्ट करके बांद्रा कोर्ट लाया जा रहा था, उस दौरान कुछ असामाजिक तत्व लोग, चाहे वो कौन है पता नहीं, यहाँ पर लॉ एंड ऑर्डर और वातावरण खराब करने की कोशिश की गई कि मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि एक दहशत फैलाने का काम किया गया, जिसकी वजह से काफी पथराव किया गया गाड़ियों पर और आते जाते वाले आदमियों को उत्तर भारतीय के नाम से इस तरीके से मारा पीटा गया।
एंड इट्स नॉट जस्ट द पीपल फ्रॉम नॉर्थ इंडिया हु हैव टू फेस द रॉथ ऑफ राज ठाकरेज अनरूली मेन। South Indians too are meted out the same treatment. 40-year-old Sheikh Abdul Naeem has been working as an auto driver in Mumbai since 1996. A resident of Bandra West, Naeem tells us that his parents had moved to Mumbai from Gulbarg in Karnataka in the early 70s.
ये राजनीति कुछ भी बोलते रहेंगे। रिक्शा बंद करना पड़ता है, घर में बैठना पड़ता है रिक्शा बंद करके। पब्लिक को निकलते नहीं है, तो रिक्शा लेके निकल के मतलब ही क्या है? पब्लिक रहेगी जब रिक्शा चला सकते हैं ना, पब्लिक ही नहीं रिक्शा चला के मतलब क्या? उसे घर में बैठना पड़ता है जी। हाँ, नुकसान तो होता ही है, कांच भी फोड़ देते, गाड़ी चला देते हैं।
From Shahrukh Khan to Amitabh Bachchan, from the Tatas to the Ambanis, this is a city that has embraced talent with open arms. Auto rickshaw and taxi drivers who targeted time and again by the MNS and the Shiv Sena claim it's nothing but a cheap political stunt. They feel that to be a Mumbaikar, you don't need a birth certificate. All you need is a desire to live in the city of dreams. Akasha Siddiqui in Mumbai, Simi Pasha for the Election Express.
Migrants are a reality of Mumbai and no party seems to have solutions for them. This lady has a question. Go ahead.
Okay, hi, I'm Parinita Banerjee and I'm a Bengali from Assam, and I can proudly say that I'm campaigning for Mr. Milind Deora because I'm willing to accept a party who's trying to bring a change. I'm willing to allow a party who is ready to correct their past failures, but I'm not willing to, go ahead for a party who puts up the state before a country. I mean, we are in a democracy. Anywhere I can go in India and pursue my education, pursue my career. I mean, why do people have their conditions and just to bring their own, state, their favoritism or their biasness towards their state? I mean, why will someone from outside ever vote for them? I mean, I go to Shiv Sena website and it's so difficult for me to find a translation link there, and everything is written in Marathi. So if someone wants to vote for them, I mean, it's impossible.
Why is Shiv Sena? When you say, madam, that it's a me Mumbaikar, that's the idea that everyone's free to vote. Why is it that the Shiv Sena appeals only to the Maharashtrians and not to people who come from Assam and Bengal?
I really appreciate her effort to go on the Shiv Sena site and search for the English. We are very much trying to make the website into English, and the Yuva Sena website is very much into English. There are so many things which are in English, but we need to upgrade, and it is going through a stage of, it is evolving. But definitely at one point of time...
How long will this evolution take? It's almost like mankind taking like several years.
I don't think so. You should appreciate something somewhere. Come on. You can't be critical about every single point when it comes to Shiv Sena, But I'm really thankful, and next time you come to the website, you will find link which will...
No, she could come tomorrow morning and not find much of a difference. Yes, you have a question.
Yeah, I am a Bombaykar. I am an East Indian. I have no problem with migrants coming over. We never had problem with the migrants coming here. But when the migrants have increased in number, And they are now bringing their own political leaders over here, like Mayawati, Mulayam Singh Yadav, Lalu Prasad Yadav. Will they come over here and rule over Bombay?
We have a representative from the Samajwadi Party. That when you come, you appeal to a very niche constituency, only the migrants. When the SP or the BSP campaigns, it's never campaigning for all of Mumbai, it's campaigning only for those whom it claims to represent, who are essentially coming from the hinterlands.
No, Rahul, I would like to clarify, that's a misconception. Not at all. We are here for the country. Samajwadi Party, Mumbai, Maharashtra, I am talking of, in the leadership of Mr. Abu Asim Azmi. Please get yourself.
Who makes the strangest comment?
I will answer that. Who thinks it's not okay for women to have sex?
Who gets reprimanded by his own daughter-in-law, and then you claim to represent India's most liberal city?
These are the people who need to be ostracized, not to talk about who's seeking which vote.
China.
You don't have the basic respect for a woman in this city, for that matter in this country.
China.
I think you need to be booed out of our home state.
China, I know you cannot face my answers, BJP and Shishana. I know I have defeated you many a times on the show, on many channels and all that.
Why didn't you answer
that? I am answering that, you know. Will you please ask Shaina to be a disciplined one? She is the daughter of Mr. Nana Chudasu. We all Mumbaikas respect him. But not to disturb, you know. How can I answer if she is going to disturb him? I tell you, I would clarify. Mr. Azmi, my party, myself, we all respect the women. To the highest level.
Let me finish.
Mr. Azmi never said hang somebody who is being raped. Not at all. It was clarified later in the next press conference. And on the very same day, please, I talked to the reporter of midday, and he felt sorry. He couldn't answer me. That when he asked two questions, you know.
Mulayam also made the similar sort of comment and then said he'd been misunderstood.
Rahul,
that makes no sense.
Rahul, you have given a lot of time to everybody. You must be pleased.
Yes, I am.
Otherwise,
but you're not giving me an
answer. I'll tell you. We definitely. Yeah, I know there are many people representing BJP and Shishana, especially BJP, because they want a person who is accused of, you know what, I'm not going to talk about.
No, answer the question that you're being asked.
I mean, the comments which is coming from shame and this and that. Please have guts. Be brave to listen to the answer, you know.
You're talking lies.
Answer the question, sir.
I'm answering the question. See, we at Samajwadi Party, and I would say all the Indians, except a handful of the high society, the so-called high society, believe that the premarital and extramarital sex is not correct. It is polluting the society. Please listen to me carefully. And we
there are some young women who have their hand up. Just one second. I'm abhorred by the fact that you would say that.
Rahul.
I absolutely will not accept it. You've spoken
don't
enough.
Don't accept it. Don't accept it. Listen to me.
We've heard you.
Give me a few.
You made a point. We disagree with it.
I am saying all these rapes, crimes, lots of crimes are happening because of this, because of the extra and premarital. We must put a ban to it, you know. We must put a ban to it.
One second, let's make the answer. No, you can't yell everyone down. You've spoken enough.
Last two sentences, please.
As a young, as a woman, what do you make of such comments?
Last two sentences.
No, one second. This is not okay. No, that lady has a hand up.
Last two sentences, please. Last two sentences. I know I'm going to write against
when you say you beat people on shows, is this what you're saying?
Yes. I know I'm riding against the wind here. Let me tell you, how many present here and how many citizens of Mumbai would like their daughters, their sisters, their mothers and otherwise, their brothers, their fathers and all, to have extramarital or premarital, knowingly I would allow, you know. Let me ask. The girl who's going to ask you. I'll ask you.
One second. This is not okay. Yes, Preeti.
No, this is not okay. The women here don't accept it. We are not going to listen to this. We are not going to let anybody take away our right to live in this country as an equal citizen. There is absolutely no question of the Samajwadi Party being allowed to get away with it. There is not a single woman in the country who is ever going to vote for them. Forget women. I know the men here will not vote for them. Because the men of Mumbai will not tolerate this kind of absolute misogyny. I mean, what kind of bigots are they? How do they have the courage to come on national television and actually say this? That rape occurs because women have
Then he says Mulayam got misunderstood. There's a young lady over there who has a hand out. One second, I want to go across to them and understand from them what they make, because they feel the Samajwadi Party thinks. You've spoken enough. Let the young woman speak. What you're saying impacts everyone.
I have to say that, you know, there is this conception that, you know, a woman who wears, Western wear gets raped more. Highest number of rapes are in rural India. They're in those parts of India where women are, you know, in saris and in a Western outfit.
Okay.
So how can you say that, you know, what are we talking about? Premarital sex?
Is it okay for your son or... One second. Only your daughter you have a problem with, Miss... So no, only no, your daughter having sex before marriage you have a problem
please,
with?
Yeah. Please do not make it personalized.
I just wanted
not
to ask you some
it.
Question. You are yes, against premarital sex, you are against extramarital sex. So but have you ever missed on pictures police. Like dirty picture or any other thing where you know these things are shown on random and I'm very sure that you guys secretly go and watch those movies.
We don't know whether he watches that stuff or not. But one second. You sir, one second. The Samajwadi Party only has a problem with but daughters having sex before marriage. Boys having sex before marriage is okay.
Mistaken.
I'm asking
first.
You.
No, I said first. You did not listen to me.
Of course I heard you.
You have come with a pre-made mind, my
no,
friend.
No, because my mind
no,
is
no,
that
no, 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 no. I told
we
you
must
that
have libertarian values.
I told you, the daughters, the mothers, the aunts, and controversy, vice versa. You know the boys. I said the sons, the fathers and all, you know.
No, no, one second. I want to go back and I want to get another sense from young women what they make. What do you want to tell him?
I would just like to say that this is absolutely ridiculous with due respect to you, sir, yes, that you sure. say that premarital, you know, no, women having premarital sex, they land up getting raped and all. What about the security issues?
I never said that.
Of course you
did
say that.
I said it leads to that, you know, the environment gets polluted, you know.
No, this is utter chauvinism when you say.
No.
Chauvinistic comments of the sorts that you've made that create problems for young girls, sir. You should be ashamed of what you're saying.
I am not. Why should I be ashamed of it?
Well, one second. How many in this audience? One second. Let's do a show of hands. Hear my question, then put your hand up. How many in this audience agree with the position that the Samajwadi Party has taken? Does anybody agree with this position? Just one second. How many disagree and want to boo the Samajwadi Party for what they're saying? Sir, I think the people of Mumbai are speaking. You're in the wrong place, making absolutely the wrong comment.
Now,
one
second. Now, let me tell you.
The rapist never asked whether you are having an extramarital affair or you have had premarital sex ever. So that
and in fact, in most of the cases, the rapists do not even know the physical appearance of the girl. It's just that they want it for the physical, you know, they just want to go and rape and finish with the sort of rapes that they have to inside them.
Rahul,
one second.
Rahul, see, this gathering does not represent India.
You represent India.
No. My idea.
Who decides who represents
India? If you want to have a debate on this, go and ask thousands, lakhs of people in the country, you know, and you get the answer.
No, Milind Deora.
One second.
Don't fight with me. I'm not fighting with you.
These are people who are your allies. Rahul,
they are your allies. It's they who helped your government survive on this while, Milind.
They are bound to speak against Samajwadi Party.
Your government survived because of their help.
Rahul, with due respect.
One second. I can't allow you to monopolize the debate. Sit down. These are people your government survived with their help.
Rather than saying who's ally, why are you wasting so much time for TRPs on this issue? The people know that it's a non-entity. No one agrees with them. Why are you were talking about the migrant issue? It's a non-entity. It's a ridiculous issue.
I object to your view that
the House disagrees unanimously with what he's saying.
My beautiful
chapter closed. Now coming to the migrant issue, if I can bring that in.
Yes.
Because we deviated a lot in the last few minutes. You know, see, ultimately a place like Mumbai is a melting ground for all people of India. And I think like the young girl who said very openly that she's involved in my campaign, that's a fear that people have across communities. It's not only someone who's from Bengal or from Assam. Could be someone who's from Gujarat, could be someone who's from Rajasthan, could be a North Indian, could be a Muslim, could be a South Indian. That kind of politics, unfortunately, still exists in Mumbai. Even though my friend from the Shiv Sena would like to say her party is reformed and they're evolving and creating an English link to their website, Shiv Sena and MNS, which is obviously old wine in a new bottle, these parties still fan fears amongst Maharashtrians. They keep them pushed in a corner. They tell them that if we don't fight these North Indians and these migrants and these Gujaratis and these South Indians,
so many years besides appealing sections from
North India. One second. मिलिंद देवरा जी आप बहुत गलत बोल रहे हो मेरा नाम धर्म मिश्रा है और मैं उत्तर भारतीय हूँ और मुझे शिवसेना पार्टी में ही हूँ आप बहुत गलत बोल रहे हो
दिस इज नॉट फॉर मी टू फॉर मिस्टर मिश्रा टू
आपने तो यही एलिगेशन लगाया है ना
ये कि ये एलिगेशन नहीं है ये सच्चाई है
सच्चाई
पूरी मुंबई
में है हम तो सड़क पे हमको कभी फियर नहीं है हमको कुछ नहीं है आप कभी सड़क पे आते ही नहीं हो
पर शिवसेना मराठी वोटर्स को ज्यादा अपील करती है नॉर्थ इंडियंस को कोशिश
ऐसा है ही नहीं, ऐसा है ही नहीं. आप बताइए कहाँ फैक्ट है, कहाँ प्रूफ है.
एवरी वोटर इज इंपॉर्टेंट.
ऐसा कुछ है ही नहीं.
लेट मी से समथिंग, डोंट आस्क मी दिस. आई एम अ कांग्रेसमैन. Don't ask China NC this, she's from BJP. Don't ask this gentleman who's from Shiv Sena. Poll anyone in Mumbai. Go on the streets and talk to anyone. Ask them if they are Gujaratis, if they are Marwadis, if they are North Indians, if they are South Indians, whether they will ever vote for Shiv Sena. Don't ask me that. Ask them that.
Okay, one second.
You know,
there's some more people who want to speak. Just one second.
This is also a sign of arrogance. 1 minute. You cannot assume that somebody...
Now what you said... Ask them whether they will vote for us. If they have not voted, we were not in the BMC. We have won the election with the help of our, many of our padadhikaris. They are not all North Indians, South Indians. How you can say that?
शिवसेनेचं नेहमी धोरण राहिलेलं आहे की मराठीत महाराष्ट्रात ते मराठी आणि देशात हिंदू. जर तुम्ही स्थानिक लोकांना या ठिकाणी स्थानिक जे मराठी माणसं आहेत, लोकल मुंबईकर आहेत, तो भले गुजराती असो, मारवाडी असो किंवा मुसलमान असो, कोणत्याही पक्षाचा असो, त्याला जर तुम्ही स्थानिक मुंबईकराला जर डावळून या ठिकाणी उत्तर भारतीय किंवा दुसऱ्या पक्षाचे कोणतेही लोक आहेत त्या ठिकाणी जर तुम्ही त्यांना नोकऱ्या आणि त्यांना एम्प्लॉयमेंट देणार असेल तर शिवसेना सदैव त्याच्या विरोधात राहिलेली आहे. माननीय शिवसेना प्रमुख बाळासाहेब ठाकरेंचेही विचार होते आणि तेच विचार आम्ही पुढे नेतो.
दॅट्स अ पॉईंट दॅट वॉज मेड अर्लियर एज वेल, दॅट द शिवसेना इज चेंजिंग, इट्स नॉट एज क्लोज एज इट वॉज earlier, and there's a new approach which is the
approach which includes
everyone. One by one. Yes.
I'll answer that because I have a Shiv Sena candidate fighting against me. I'll tell you what they're trying to spin. They are trying to say that there is a alleged Modi wave in the country. So if you are a Gujarati, Marwadi, North Indian, we are a Todfod party. We and our cousin MNS are full Todfod parties.
Estranged
but
cousin.
If you want estranged cousin or whatever, but if you want Mr. Modi, vote for us and we are answer. People understand what Shiv Sena is about. People understand what MNS is about.
One.
Down the line, I see this every day because there's an MP from South Mumbai. Every day, small traders, people from different communities, even Maharashtrians, come to me and complain about the excesses Rahul about of Shiv Sena and MNS.
Yes, one second. The Shiv Sena must be allowed to answer.
Partiality to the sitting member of
parliament. He came late. You spoke
Rahul
initially
Rahul
the most.
Came late, but you gave him the entire debate.
No, no, of course not. Yes, yes, one by one, one by one. You are allies. Don't fight. Yes, just one by one. You decide who speaks first. Yes.
Go ahead. First, then I'll speak. With reference to what Milind spoke just now, in fact, I think entire Mumbai, you said you can ask anyone that what he feels about Shiv Sena, etc. On the contrary, I would say Mumbai is such a place in the world map where anybody is welcome and he lives happily and he works happily. There is no issue whatsoever. What they are fearing is the security which this non-performing government is not giving to the ordinary citizens of the country.
We have to protect people from parties like you.
Not at all.
Yes, China.
I think we've had enough of this kind of debate which suggests that the Shiv Sena is for the Marathi Manus, etc. We are all for every citizen who lives in Maharashtra. It could be somebody who has come from outside, it could be somebody who exists here. The question you need to ask the Member of Parliament is what is he doing to ensure that the 40% of tax that goes from this city, what is coming back to us in terms of infrastructure, is all the projects which are lying in cold storage, are they ever going to be completed? Is it going to improve the life of the normal Mumbaikar who could be Maharashtrian, North Indian, Gujarati, Marathi, whatever? The point is that if you're going to deliver on systems, ensure that this city is a better city, we get a special package, are you going to fight for all of that?
Okay.
Or are you going to say this person's not going to vote
for you?
You know,
we've spoken so far to the haves, but what about the have-nots? Because Mumbai is as much about the have-nots as it is about the haves. The haves are seen more often on television than the have-nots, but what we did earlier in the day was get into Dharavi, Asia's largest slum, to understand what the issues of people in Dharavi are. What is it that they're looking up to their netas to deliver in the battle for your vote 2014? Here's what we found out. We are in the heart of Dharavi, Asia's biggest slum, to understand what the inhabitants of Dharavi feel about your vote 2014. We've got a cross-section of the residents of Dharavi with us. सबसे पहले सर आपसे शुरू करना चाहते हैं और जानना ये चाहेंगे कि धारावी में इतने सारे जो लोग रहते हैं, आपके हिसाब से सबसे बड़ी समस्याएं जो हैं इस चुनाव की क्या हैं?
इस चुनाव की धारावी के लिए तो बड़ी समस्या है. हम लोग को झोपड़पट्टी, गटर नहीं बराबर, रोडें नहीं बराबर, और समझ लो अभी एक नया ये लोग ने इश्यू लाया है स्काई वॉक का, जबकि रोड 37 फीट का है, 5 फीट का पिलर डालेंगे तो 16 फीट में गाड़ियां पास नहीं हो सकती है। और इंडस्ट्रियल एरिया है हमारा, यहाँ पे इंडस्ट्रियल एरिया में बड़ी बड़ी गाड़ियां आती है तो टर्न नहीं हो सकती, मतलब यहाँ स्काई वॉक की जरूरत नहीं है, फिर भी उन्होंने स्काई वॉक
आएगा तो आप ही लोगों को फायदा होगा।
नहीं, कुछ फायदा नहीं है स्काई वॉक पे। आप बताइए मेरे को कि जहाँ जहाँ भी बना है कहीं पे लोग चढ़ते हैं।
कि सरकार चाहती है कि जो धारावी में लोग रह रहे उनको रीसेटल किया जाए, उनको पक्की इमारतें दी जाए। आपको क्या लग रहा है कौन सी पार्टी है या कौन वो लोग हैं जो कि धारावी के समस्याओं का समाधान कर सकते?
मुझे तो इस टाइम पे कोई नेता ऐसा दिख नहीं रहा जो धारावी का समाधान करे। सब नेता लोग जो भी है इस धारावी को बेचने के चक्कर में लगे हुए है, चाहे कांग्रेस पार्टी का नेता हो, चाहे सेना पार्टी का नेता हो, चाहे अन्य कोई भी पार्टी का नेता हो, सबकी नजर धारावी के ऊपर गड़ी हुई है, धारावी वासियों पे गड़ी हुई है। आज धारावी वासी किस समस्या से गुजर रहा उनको इस विषय में लेना देना नहीं है, इनको सिर्फ अपना मुद्दा लेना है और अपना जेब गर्म करना है। इसके लिए धारावी वासी बहुत नाराज है इस टाइम पे।
सर, अमूमन ये कहा जाता है कि धारावी के लोगों को वोट बैंक की तरह इस्तेमाल करती हैं पार्टियां, आपको भी ऐसा लगता है?
हाँ बराबर, बिल्कुल। वोट बैंक जब भी इनका चुनाव आता है ना तो फिर आते हैं घर पे पूछने के लिए कि क्या है, पानी है, इलेक्ट्रिसिटी सब है, रोड कैसा है, बच्चे कैसे हैं, उसके बाद पूछते नहीं, सब अपनापन दिखाते हैं। उसके बाद कोई भी समस्या लेके उनके पास जो ऑफिस में तो बोलते नहीं, उनके पास टाइम ही नहीं है।
मैं धारावी की युवा जो वोटर है उनसे जानना चाहता हूँ कि आपसे आपके हिसाब से कौन है जो कि यहाँ की प्रॉब्लम्स को सॉल्व कर सकता है, जो आपको रोजगार दे सकता है, जो आपकी जिंदगी की हालत को बेहतर कर सकता है?
अभी कहा बताओ, सब वैसी है, वैसी तो है, कोई अच्छा करता ही नहीं है। सब बोल के जाएंगे कि ये कर दूंगा वो कर दूंगा, दूसरा कोई करता ही नहीं है, कोई कुछ करता ही नहीं।
तो आपका क्या मन बन रहा है, किसको आप लोग वोट देना चाहते हैं?
अभी देखो, अभी सब जिस पे देंगे अभी आप उस पे अपन भी देंगे, और क्या बोले।
तो ये ऐसा क्यों होता है कि सब लोग मिलकर डिसाइड करते हैं कि किसको वोट करना है, आप लोग अलग अलग क्यों नहीं डिसाइड करते हो कि किसको वोट देना चाहिए? एक कम्युनिटी मतलब एक बार मिल के फैसला क्यों होता है?
एक बार क्या मिल के फैसला था, कहीं कोई जीतेगा कहीं कोई जीतेगा तो मतलब ये भेल भाल पार्टी हो जाती है। एक पार्टी आने के बाद अभी जैसे कांग्रेस आ गए तो इतना महंगाई, अभी 2-3 रुपए किलो राशन दे रहे, वो भी कितना इलेक्शन तक, उसके बाद तो राशन वाले राशन भी बंद कर देते हैं, खाने पीने का इतना मुश्किल कर डालते हैं कि क्या बताएं। और अगर आरटीआई का पेपर मारेंगे तो ये बीएमसी वाले इतना दौड़ाते हैं, बोलते हैं हमारे पास है नहीं ऑफिसर, उनके बड़े ऑफिसर मिले तो उनसे भी कोई मतलब रिस्पॉन्ड अपने को मिलते ही नहीं, मतलब खाली चप्पल घसना होता है।
तो इन सब समस्याओं का कोई समाधान है आपके हिसाब से कि नहीं?
क्या समाधान बताएं, अभी उनको समझ में नहीं आता कोई समाधान, क्योंकि एक पार्टी कोई भी आएगी, लीगल पार्टी कोई भी आएगी तो ही कोई काम बनेगा।
यहाँ की महिलाओं की क्या समस्या है, क्या क्या प्रॉब्लम होगी?
बहुत प्रॉब्लम है, लैट्रिन प्रॉब्लम, हर चीज़ की सफाई नहीं, गंदगी नहीं, हर चीज़ की तो प्रॉब्लम है। कितनी प्रॉब्लम बताएंगे आपको, क्या सॉल्व करोगे? बहुत सी प्रॉब्लम।
आपके हिसाब से कोई नेता है, कोई पार्टी है जो इन प्रॉब्लम्स को सॉल्व करना चाहता है?
कुछ नेता भी इधर खाली अपने अपने भरते हैं, कोई किसी का कुछ नहीं देखते हैं।
तो चुनाव के बाद कोई आता है, क्योंकि चुनाव के टाइम पे मैं देख रहा हूँ बड़े सारे नेता
आते हैं, बाद में भी आते हैं, नगर सेवक के जो झाड़ू नाली साफ कराने वाले आते हैं।
तो आपके हिसाब से यहाँ की समस्याओं का सलूशन क्या है?
क्या बताएं, यानी कुछ बोल नहीं सकते, बहुत सी प्रॉब्लम है मगर बोल नहीं सकते।
क्यों बोल नहीं सकते आप?
अरे यहाँ किसको बोले, जो सुनता ही नहीं है सही से, सब अपनी अपनी यानी जितने भी साइड में रहते हैं, थोड़ा बहुत तो हल्का फुल्का काम करते, कोई ज्यादा भारी।
लोग आज जमाने से झोपड़पट्टी में ही रह रहे, हमारे लिए कुछ सोच रहे नहीं है, कांग्रेस आ रही जा रही आ रही जा रही, ये सब हम लोग के कब हम लोग को बिल्डिंग बना के देंगे, हम लोग को कितनी परेशानियाँ है सब चीज की, वही सब है और क्या।
तो किसी पार्टी से उम्मीद बन रही आपकी?
हम लोग की कांग्रेस से ही थी और है भी, लेकिन अभी तक तो कुछ किया नहीं हमारे लिए।
तो ऐसा क्यों होता है कि चुनाव से पहले आते हो फिर भाग के चले जाते हो?
अब ये नहीं मालूम क्यों आ रहे नहीं जा रहे नहीं।
आप क्या चाहती है पार्टियों से, क्या आपकी प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व करनी?
हम लोग यही चाहते हैं कि हम लोग का सब घर अच्छे से बन जाए, सबको सबका घर मिले यहाँ पर, हम लोग यही चाहते हैं।
खत्म हो गई है यहीं पर बेटा, हम लोग के आदमी नहीं है, गरीब आदमी हम लोग
हैं। तो आपके हिसाब से क्या यहाँ की प्रॉब्लम है जिनको नेताओं ने सॉल्व नहीं?
हमको यही चाहिए घर बना के दे दो बेटा, और कुछ नहीं चाहिए मेरे को,
कहीं नहीं। हम लोग यही रहना चाहते हैं, हम लोग को यहाँ घर चाहिए।
नहीं, क्योंकि पार्टियाँ कहती हैं कि कहीं और बसा सकते हैं धारावी के लोगों को।
नहीं बेटा, हम लोग को यही चाहिए, यही बना के, जो भी चाहिए जैसा भी चालिए बनाइए, कैसा बना के
चाली बना के दे, लेकिन हम लोग यही रहेंगे। हम लोग
सरकार कहती है कि पक्की इमारत देगी दूसरी जगह पे,
पता नहीं देगी और कहीं दूर फेंक देगी तो हम लोग क्या करेंगे? हम लोग के बच्चे पढ़ते हैं,
छोटे छोटे पढ़ते हैं, हम लोग के स्कूल यहाँ है, बच्चों के स्कूल यहाँ पर है बेटा, बच्चों के छोटे छोटे बच्चे हैं, हम लोग के यही चाहिए। यहीं बना के दे, हम गरीब लोग हैं, हम लोग खाने
को सरकार कहती कि यहाँ पे
राशन नहीं, खाने को नहीं, कुछ नहीं, यहाँ पर हम लोग को सब जगह मिलता है, यहाँ नहीं मिलता है।
पर सरकार कहती कि यहाँ पे जगह नहीं है इतनी पक्की इमारतें बनाने के लिए, इसलिए वो बाहर पे जगह पकड़ रहे हैं।
नहीं, हम लोग को यहीं चाहिए, बाहर नहीं चाहिए,
नहीं चाहिए हम लोग को बाहर, हम लोग को यहीं चाहिए,
हम लोग यही जगह पर भले छोटी जैसा है वैसा ही बना के दे दीजिए, हम लोग को बैठी चाल बना दीजिए, बस हम लोग यहीं रहने वाले हैं।
फ्रॉम द सर्जिंग एक्सपेक्टेशंस इन द रेस्ट ऑफ मुंबई टू द हार्श रियलिटीज ऑफ द क्लियरली द एस्पिरेशन दैट नरेंद्र मोदी हैज बीन एबल टू बिल्ड अराउंड हिज स्टोरी नॉट बीइंग विजिबल हियर ऑन द ग्राउंड इन धारावी, देयर आर अदर्स हु माइट बिलीव दैट ही कैन चेंज देयर फॉर्च्यून्स एंड ब्रिंग बैक द इंडिया ग्रोथ स्टोरी, दैट ऑप्टिमिज्म दैट सेंस नॉट फेल्ट इन एशियाज बिगेस्ट स्लम।
The only time they see politicians, they say, is before elections. And what a shame that is. Treated as a vote bank, exploited, but never rewarded. Let's take some more questions. Zala.
Oh, my question is to Sir Milind personally. Sir, the policy was the Bandrawali ceiling stated that the expenditure should be rupees 400 crores, if I'm not mistaken. But however, the Bandrawali ceiling to be constructed has taken rupees already 1600 crores and plus has been 10 years delayed. So, sir, what, isn't it a breach of the policy made by the government?
Yes,
yeah, well, it's a good question if it's about infrastructure delays. This is something I've been saying in various debates on various TV channels and for many, many years. And I think it's good that people talk about it during election time because it can be made hopefully a political issue. You know, firstly, let's look at Mumbai's problems, whether it's railways, whether it's public transportation, whether it's housing, whether it's sanitation, whatever the local issues are. A major problem in Mumbai city, which is very different from Delhi, mind you, is that in Mumbai city we elect 269 elected representatives, 227 of whom are municipal councillors, 36 are MLAs, 6 are MPs. We don't elect one person who's in charge of the entire city and who's directly accountable to the entire city. And that's
so you had a chance to change it, why didn't you?
It's not only you, we had the chance, I'll explain it. Unfortunately, the problem is that there are so many agencies running Mumbai. There are some agencies which fall under the state government, some under the central government and some under the local agency. There is a plan which unfortunately hasn't found political consensus. It's not about political will. It requires political consensus, which is that if we can have a directly elected mayor on the lines of what you have in other cities like say New York for example, where you'll have a more empowered mayor.
Do it, you've had a chance.
No, it's not, Rahul, it's not about do it. The problem is the minute it's proposed, what happens is certain political parties try and politicize it and say it's a Mumbai versus Maharashtra debate and it goes for a spin. So here's something I'm suggesting in a very constructive way, not in a political way. They're representatives of different political parties. I've said this before to some of them also. That's a solution which I think is a very important solution for Mumbai, which will allow a lot of these agencies to be converged, come under one roof, there will be direct accountability on one person, that person will have to face the electorate every 5 years and things will move much, much faster the way it does in New York or in London in any large metropolis. And I think if all political parties can say that we agree on it in principle, because it's not suggesting taking Mumbai out of Maharashtra, it's not suggesting any of those emotive cultural issues that people get agitated about. It's just restructuring power,
okay.
It's just devolving power from the state to the city. It requires the city, the municipality, the state government to work together. The interesting thing is that 6 months later, the assembly goes in for a poll also. So I think if we can drum up enough support, this could become a large enough political issue that could actually see the light of day and change the entire structure of governance in Mumbai city.
Stay with us. We'll continue this conversation. What I do now is give you a sense of all of what's made news through the day today. So here is, just in the next 10 minutes, a snippet of all the big stories from the day.